Good morning, one and all, joining us on ESNF's platform. I'm Ashwar, and today we are having one of the most graceful, dedicated, and talented educator. Her expertise lies in both national and international boards. She has been honored by some of the most prestigious awards: Best in Academic Leader, Best Academic Leader, Bharat Vidya Shiromani, Jewel of India, Siksha Bharati, Nari Shakti, National Builder Award by Rotary, Pride of India, Educational Icon 2018, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Professional Excellence Award, Education Queen, Miss Role Model. They are just few of them, but there are so many that she has achieved. She is the President of Maharashtra Education Policy and the current principal. She is currently serving as the director principal. So this is being an immense privilege to have her today on ESNF's platform. So I'm Ashwar, director of ESNF, welcoming you in behalf of team. And before sharing the platform with her, I would like to tell you one thing about her, that her motto of living is I am because we are. So everything in her life is just because we are. So madam, now the platform is all yours, and I would request you to introduce once by yourself, please.
Thank you so much, and namaskar everyone. First of all, it's very nice to see that the young generation has taken a lead, and they are coming up with these kind of conversation. It gives me immense pleasure when I see that the future generation is there, ready to learn and ready to share. So Aishwarya, it's a wonderful platform, and heartiest congratulations that being so young, you are getting in touch with not just education, but I think with people across the globe, and you are having these kind of conversation. These meaningful conversation definitely lead us to a better world, and together then we understand the generational disparity. If I have to introduce myself, I think the introduction will be a little bit different than what you have introduced, because that was very professional one. So my introduction is, there is nothing that ends with ING which I have not done, whether it's paragliding, parachuting, horse riding, scuba diving, tracking. Maybe there are certain new INGs which are added now that I might have not done, otherwise I have done everything. Because I feel a lot of adventure when you are a part of that, and when you go beyond your something that you are scared of, you understand life from a different perspective. And I think that is what succeeded me when I became a teacher, when I decided that I want to go ahead with teaching, because those stories of my experience were something that my students used to look forward to. So for me, everything is a story, every human is a story, and we need to ensure that we present our story well. So I'm just a simple, humble person. Yes, rightly said, I believe in I am because we are, because alone we are just a drop in the ocean, but together we are the mighty ocean. So I think this pandemic has taught us how important is it to collaborate and believe in the power of we. See, alone, whatever we have, however rich we are, whatever knowledge we have, but we need somebody to share that knowledge with. We need somebody to enjoy our richness. So if the power of we supersedes the power of we for me.
That's really amazing, because mostly I saw...
Your voice is not audible.
I'm sorry. Mostly the principal that I saw, and being a director principal you are, so there are mostly principal those who are having a boring nature with always a sad face, and their eyebrows are always straight, and they are being always shouting on the children for making them disciplined. So this is the basic motive. But you are too young. I saw one interview in which there is some conversation with your age. So may I know what age you are having?
That's a good question. Not difficult to answer. I will soon after a few years turn 50. So I mean, that's life. You have to enjoy your age. I am 46 right now, and I'm so proud to say that. Why should we? I'm trying to hide our age. I do not believe in the concept of hiding your age. Age makes you learn so many things, and I have learned. I have seen 46 summers of my life. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, that's really great. So, madam, tell me that from from SEMA, the travel, how you travel for a principal or a director principal, how this travel happens. Tell us a brief about this, please.
The travel was very smooth. I was always an extraordinary person. When it comes to ideas, I'm not talking about academics, because academics is just one part of your life. Yes, I was always a person who liked to experiment, who liked to experience. So I started my journey from corporate long back in 1994, and after that I came to education. And once I came to education, there was no looking back, because I feel, and now I think I feel a better connect, because we need to prepare our children for uncertain future. We need to prepare our children for the corporate world. So to bring the practice of corporate world to education world and to amalgamate both and then prepare our children, that is something I love to do. And right now also we are working out on increasing the social scores of our children so that they are ready for the world which is more complex, which is more demanding. So for example, if the corporate world looks for more of collaboration or teamwork or team spirit, that needs to start from school. I firmly believe that everything starts from school. We do not have to invest so much of money in corporate training if we train our children right from the school and give the ready and prepared children to the global market.
That's really amazing.
So the journey was smooth, because I was a part of journey. I have taken that journey on my own. So it was really smooth. Not that there were no hurdles, but there was no hurdles so immense that it could stop me. So I don't think there was something which was a major barricade. Challenges were there, and challenges need to be there.
That's really amazing, because you are belonging with a so so cool ideology. Okay, and that's really amazing. And I have one more thing that I have to ask, like what are the innovative ideas and what are the innovative programs that you are making for the students, those who are everyone has suffered from the pandemic, but the highest effect, as we can see, on the education world. And what are you doing for the students of grade 10th and 12th, because they have board examinations this year, and same for the previous year that we have seen, because every tuitions, coachings and institutions as well as school are also closed. So what are the programs, extraordinary things that you are doing?
So the best part or the worst part, I don't know, but this new school, Sanjeevani World School, which are setting up right now, it's taking its baby step. Our students are in grade 9 right now, so I don't have that much of stress of board examination, and so do my students. But then again, when it comes to board, I think I will never give that kind of stress to my students, and also if my parents, if they are listening to me, though they know that I'm very vocal about it, that we should never give stress to our children. Education should not be mark-centric. Education needs to be life-centric. It needs to be more dynamic. I do not want to see children only getting 99% and 100% and failing in life. A child needs to be ready for life. Maybe if the child has got 87% or 85%, but the child is more holistic because the child is ready to adapt to any situation, I think that is the ideal learner for me. And these are the practices we are very, very firm in our school. The parents who have joined our school, they know our ideology. Maybe after 1 year, when my children will appear for the grade 10 examination, nobody will ever see a board outside the school that these are the 5 toppers or 8 toppers. No. If there are 27 students I have in grade 9, or if there will be more students also in grade 10, all the children need to be there on that poster. Everybody has achieved something. So in our school, we do not say report card day or open house. It is the achiever's day. Everybody has achieved something and moved to another grade. So it is their achievement. And I think it is completely wrong to tag a child with the kind of percentage the child gets. Maybe a child is too inclined towards sports. So that is also an asset to the nation. Why should we only see that the children who are getting more than 90%, they are intelligent? There are different kind of MIs we know. So each and every child possesses some kind of intelligence, and we need to appreciate that. That is what we do in our school.
Yeah, and tell me what kind of student you are in your school days. Because every student is having asked this question to their principal, because principal is somebody to whom you can't ask directly.
No, I was never the studious person. I mean, I was a above average child, but not the one who was like 99%. And as it is, as I told you, during our time, it was not the rat race of marks which is there right now. During our times, I think first class was, wow, first class, your child had passed with first class. That used to be so much. And these days, 75% or 60% is nothing, because because everybody is looking forward to 95-90%, because that is the kind of competition which is there. So I was a child who enjoyed everything. I was the one who was on the field, in the class, everywhere. So for me, this restriction was not there, or this stress was not there that I have to succeed in academics only. As I told you, I have done everything. I come from a background wherein my parents, my father was in defense, he was in Air Force. So we have the liberty to, explore the life the way we wanted to explore.
Okay, one more question that I am having, that you are coming as you are.
We missed your voice.
Yeah. I'm sorry. As one more question that I am having, with that you are coming from the lineage that, as you mentioned, and as there is a mention in your biodata, that there is you are coming from the lineage of Air Force. So can you please tell me a brief about that?
So it is like my father was in Air Force and he got retired from Air Force. So life taught us very early that we need to adapt to new situation and new place, because after every 3 years we used to get transferred to some other place. So that means you need to learn how to adapt, you need to learn how to isolate yourself from your friends and go to a new place and look for new friends. So that is something that life had taught us very early. And then coming from defense background, I know discipline is something which is ingrained, integrity towards your work and towards your own self is ingrained. So a lot of values we learn when we are a part of defense. There are a lot of values which were there in me. Rather than anybody teaching me, I learned it from my family. And my journey was very good. Kept on shifting to various places, kept on adapting new situation, kept on learning new languages. And India is a beautiful country. The more you explore, the more you fall in love with that.
Definitely. Okay, one more thing. This is a sort of informal question. Okay, this is like you are a principal, as we can see. And there are some of the people in your institution, in your school, those who are chattering on you, like upon a nature that she is being doing this kind of, because there are some works that a principal done, and they are out of the understanding of teachers and students as well. Some of the times it happens, and kai bar principal ya jiske bare mein bhi that everything happens, to unhe pata bhi chalta, like they are making some kind of rumors and talking upon me. So un cheezon ko, ups and downs ko kaise aap handle karte?
So isn't this beautiful that you are giving people reason to talk about you? People are happy because they are talking about you. Our school follows a very simple philosophy which I think my entire team follows. In our school, we do not have any vertical hierarchy, let me tell you. We have very horizontal hierarchy. I strongly believe in empowering my team. For me, nothing is more important than my students and my team. They come first and then rest everything. So they are very important. And we also believe in one maxim, that is cheers to criticism. You need to say cheers to criticism and learn from it. The day you will start seeing criticism as negative, you will shut all the doors of improvement. See, if somebody is criticizing you, pay some heed and just see how much is there which needs to be changed and how much is there which is just a part of humor. Why do we always take everything negative? Why is criticism negative? Just take something which is good out of that. So we are a very open system, and as far as my students are concerned, with my students also, we have a lot of open dialogue. We used to have during regular school. Online, we are not getting that much of time because of many constraints, but I always enjoy the open dialogue with my students in my own particular session, that was Principal Ki Paathshala. That is very, very close to my heart, because that used to be my session with the students, and we discussed everything under the sun. Apart from academics, there was no place for academics during that session. It could be anything that they wanted to discuss, and we had hearty discussions about that. So the more open you are, the more open are the conversation, the more transparent you are with your students, with your staff, with your parents, I think life is much simpler than it's up to you how you are making it. So this is what we are trying to take a school which is different in ideology, which is different in approach. And I think we have succeeded a lot also in doing that.
That's really great to listen this, because I am educating from an institution of Sindhias, and we are having some of the very they are my teachers, mentors, so I am never using such kind of words. But this is also part of teaching profession, because if you are not as strict, then you can't maintain discipline. So, madam, tell me that, like, you are a principal. So, ma'am, tell me one thing, that are you unfortunate in this profession, or you like I want like you are in the like you are unfortunate in this profession, or you had think that I want to become an educator, I want to become a teacher, or what is your aim if you don't want to become this?
No, as I told you, I was in corporate. Before that, I wanted to be a pilot because I have done my 3 years of gliding. Also, I had a glider pilot license, which is expired. It's a different thing. So I wanted to be a pilot, to tell you very honestly. So I did not become pilot, but I think still I am flying with so many students. I have so many students. I'm in life journey in my hand as a principal. Every day it gives me chance to take my students to a new destination. It is up to me how I want to that. So yes, definitely my aim started with becoming a pilot, and then I joined corporate, and after that I came to education, and after coming to education there was no looking back, and now there is no looking back. This is what I want to do. Whether I'm associated to any organization or not, I will always be a teacher first, because any principal, any director, if you are associated with school, you need to be a teacher first. If you are a teacher at heart, rest everything is just a mission.
Okay, you are connected with Rotary enough, like you are with having a very high interest in Rotary. So what are the qualities that you like in Rotary, and that's why you are connecting to Rotary?
So Rotary gives me a lot of opportunity to serve humanity, to serve society. And I think each one of us, we need to give back to society. It is not about how much money you have, how much you're contributing. It is about how much willing are you to contribute. Because at the end of the day, when you do something, when you do a deed which makes a difference, the kind of satisfaction that you get, no money can buy that satisfaction. So yes, I am a hardcore Rotarian. I joined a few years back, and I try to give my time as much as possible. If I can contribute towards society, I do that. And I think each one of us should do that, whether we are Rotarian or not. We should do that. Giving back to society should be one of the aim we should have in our life.
Yeah, that's really okay. Tell me, how can you compare the education at your time? Because there is some difference. We can see that the education at your time is different from the education that we are having. So is it good or is it bad, or what is your thinking about the education patterns, or if there is something that you want to change in the education system?
Change is the only universal constant. Okay, now today, if I talk about the education what I had, I am always very proud of my alma mater. I am very proud of the education that I got. I have studied from Kendra Vidyalaya, and I think they are one of the best institutions to offer you good education. But it is not about teaching method or pedagogy. See, with time, everything changes. Okay, every generation comes out with something new, and we have to progress. When we see the graph of progress, if we will not change, if it will become static, we are not going to progress. So we have to become dynamic. Education is dynamic, and pandemic has taught us that you cannot cling to one method. You have to go to different learning landscapes. Our entire education system has become more of blended and hybrid now. And also, at the same time, when we talk about international education, and we talk of a lot of application-based learning, inquiry-based learning, then we just have to reflect back to our Gurukul system. What was Gurukul system way of pedagogy and teaching? Was entirely experiential based and application based. The only thing is, in due course of time, we had made education only mark centric. It is very important for us to reflect back. That is why I am a very pro person when we have to speak about NEP 2020, because NEP 2020 will bring a revolution which is needed in education. And it has to. We will break the silos of subject specific studies, like you have to take science, commerce, or humanities. You'll be able to select whatever you want to study. It is more of student-centric. The aim is to make India a knowledge destination, which India always was during the time of Nalanda and Takshila. There is so much that we can learn from our own country, our own culture, our own history. But at times, we do not look back. We just look to the foreign nations. I am a very pro person to look back, take things from what we had. I mean, what we are following, it goes to the Western world, and then it is wrapped in a nice package and comes back to us. And then we are all very happy to see that thing, and we are ready to embrace that. But I think we need to take a pause and look back and see who we were. It is very important to know who we were, then only we will know where we have to go.
That's really amazing. And do tell me one more thing, that do you appreciate this virtual studies, or you aren't, or you are much touched with the practical studies that we are having in the classroom system, or you are okay with the virtual system?
So do we have any other option? When we do not have any other option, right now the option is virtual study. Right now the option is, we need not bring lot of academic gap, or need not bring lot of learning gap. So the only option was virtual. So definitely we are virtual. Whenever the things will be back to normal and schools will open, we are all ready to welcome our students. But first of all, it is very important to take care of this generation who is there at their home right now. This generation is the one who is going to build our nation after 20 years. So why not safeguard them? When you do not have any option, rather than cribbing, embrace that, adapt to that, then go ahead. And I think teachers, I mean, we started with disaster-driven digitalization, and right now, if you see, it's teacher and technology together. And so much changes we have seen in learning landscape. So right now, if virtual is the only solution, that is best. The day schools will open, definitely we'll again change what is needed. So I believe that rather than cribbing that this is not right, that is not right, whatever is the solution that time, go ahead with that and ensure that you are implementing and doing the best, keeping that solution in mind.
That's the most amazing thing that I ever have seen, that being talking to an educator, like they are having a lot to discuss and a lot to share. And if you are going to ask one question to them, and they are having, like if I ask one question to you as well, if I'm talking about you, then I'll just ask one question and you have covered three or four, so that my list is going to be shorted down. And this always happens. This always happens. Madam, if we are back to your, like if we, like tell us something about your family. Have you any son or daughter? Do you have? And
yeah, I have a daughter. I have a daughter. She's in grade 11 right now, and she's doing her A-level. She's studying. She studies on her own. She plays keyboard. She plays guitar. She sings Western music. And I'm not the parent who always tell her that, okay, this is the grade or this is the marks bracket we are looking for. She did not go for any tuition. She passed her grade 10 last year and before. She passed her grade 10 last to last year before pandemic. I had put a disclaimer on social media that whatever we celebrated a day before her result. We celebrated her efforts because I was not worried about what grades she will get. But her efforts needed to be celebrated. So we celebrated her effort that, okay, and I said, whatever you will get. And I said, purposely I'm writing on social media so that you can show me, see, this is what you have told. I said, whatever you will get, that is your own hard work. And she came out with flying colors. But my concern is, we need to give that kind of space to our children. Life is not just about 99%. Life is much more beyond that. It is not just IQ. It's IQ, EQ, SQ, AQ. Everything needs to be maintained. And that's very important. Then only we can say that the child is holistic.
That's really amazing. Or you are doing same as with your students as well.
Yes. So you have to practice first. You cannot just preach if you have not practiced.
Okay, being a principal, like you are being a principal, so what restrictions that you are having? Because we can see, like, if we are talking about my principal or the principals at here in Gwalior, so I can't, like वो हमें ऐसे दिखाई नहीं देते कि I am going to morning walk to DRD here. We never see them to, you know, doing such kind of work. So what are the restrictions, or what are the extra things that you are, like, are you doing some sort of course with your profession?
Profession is something you need to keep on upskilling yourself. I keep on doing many courses. That is why, I mean, online has given us so much of opportunity to upgrade our own skill. I just finished one of the course from Harvard Business School, which maybe I would have not done if things were just normal and regular and there was no pandemic. Because pandemic has made us realize, otherwise also I keep on upskilling myself, but pandemic made us realize that we have to escalate the speed of this thing, achieving or doing more course or sharpening our skills. Because the more we learn, the better learning we can bring back to our children. We need to know what is going to what is there that the society demands or what is there that the corporate world demands, and bring it back to your school.
Okay, tell me one thing. You are being a principal of a private school, okay? So have like this is out of your profession might be, but have you ever visited government schools or have you never touched with government schools?
I have visited government school. Why not? And as a Rotarian also, a few months back, we had installed the entire IT system and projector and other AV device in one of the common schools. So definitely, I mean, private school is a part of your profession. But when you have to give back to society, why not common school? I know the kind of digital divide which is there. Private school still are going ahead with the kind of education they wanted to give. There are many children from common schools who are suffering. Very soon, we are going to set up a library in one of the government schools, donating more than 800 books. So we have to be a part of. I mean, it's not about government school or private school. For me, it is about student, and each and every student should have the access to quality education.
Now, I ask this question because in my one visit to government school, because I have a lot, like I have listened that the government school are somewhere where the students are free-handed. Teachers are not looking towards them. So I'm very curious about looking once the government schools, and in my one visit I saw children are roaming here and there, teachers are not present in the school. So that is why I saw that private the students' life at a government school is might be not conducting a well future, I saw there. But in private schools it's totally different because everybody is focusing on you, because the school is rises by the efforts of yours, because if you are going to become something, then school itself rises and you are rising. So these are the efforts of your institution, your teachers, your principal that makes you to do that. So this will not matter much.
So I still feel it is not about government school and private school. It is a lot about teachers in general also. We have a lot of success stories from so many government schools. I mean, during pandemic also, we came to know that so many government schools teachers are going beyond their comfortable zone and reaching out to children and teaching them. So I think that becomes too individualistic to one institution. But I feel even government school teachers are doing commendable whatever efforts they are taking, whatever is available to them. They might not have those kind of means which a private school teacher has. So there is a divide there also. But at the end of the day, teachers always want to see their children succeed. You know, apart from parents, there is only a teacher who is always happy when their students supersede them. So we always want to see our children succeed. Doesn't matter whether it's a government school teacher or a private school teacher.
Really amazing answer I received. Really, this is a really an appreciating, adorable answer that I have received. And tell me that I can see you are a busy one. Are you always busy in some of the sessions? So tell me a few of the time that you are when you are free. So what are the extracurricular or co-curricular activities that you prefer to do, or there might be your hobbies? What are your hobbies that you have to do? And would you like to spend time with your families? And if you do so with your daughter, so what kind of things that you love to teach her?
So I don't teach her anything. I mean, why should I teach her? I teach in school also and at home also. If I'll be a teacher or only that won't maintain the balance which is needed, I don't teach her. I think I learn a lot from her, because we do learn from everyone. So I learn a lot from her when it comes to technology. Yes, everybody likes to spend time with their family. I also do that whenever I have my free time. When it comes to hobbies, I read, I listen to music, I do my yoga, and I connect with people around the globe. The best way these days, I mean, we have certain restrictions when it comes to travel. So otherwise, if when there was no pandemic, I'm a person who likes to travel, because travel is the best teacher. You learn a lot when you travel. Otherwise, I learn a lot from my daughter when it comes to new apps. That's much faster than going and finding out from Google. Better I go and ask her and she teaches me in a better manner. Your generation is technological driven generation. We are still learning.
Yeah, that is. And this is really a period when teachers, like in our institution, we are having too much senior educators. They are might be out of 50, 55. Might be an age of retirement after 60, according to government. But we are having experienced educator instead of the educator with, like, this is our principal's belief that instead of having a B.Ed certificate or some of the other degree certificate, you are having experience of at least 20 plus years, so that it would be much better for the students. So yeah, we are the ones who are preferring experience instead of like qualification is also important, because without qualification nothing will happen. So this is really being amazing. And one more thing that I have to ask, what time limit we are having? So I mean
we can try to finish by 5, because my school one more session is going on. I will jump in there after some time.
Okay, that's really amazing. So what sub, like you are also having some period that you are teaching in your school, so what subject you are having to teach?
So basically I am an English person, but right now I am not teaching anything, and what I teach is life. So that is what I told you, my subject, which the specific period that I have kept for me is Principal Ki Parshala, and we discuss about everything. It can be academics, it can be beyond academics, it can be life, it can be movie, it can be anything and everything. Because students' voice needs to be heard. Students, they have so much. They have so much of ideas, so much of innovative ideas, so much of ideas which came out of the research that they do. Or sometimes they just want somebody to listen to them. So I prefer to give them that kind of space wherein each and every child can speak whatever he or she wanted to speak without being judgmental about them. So very, very non-judgmental period. No record keeping for them what they have told or something. It is like hearty, open discussions.
It's really being amazing to talk to you, and the thing that's very
I again lost you. Can't hear you.
Okay. Actually, there are some protocols that I also have to follow, because there are. So yeah. So leave. One more formal question, that what weather is happening in Mumbai?
I can't hear you. You will repeat it again.
What is the weather in Mumbai?
Mumbai, it was raining since morning, and tomorrow is Ganpati festival. It usually rains during Ganpati, and Mumbai is right now in high spirits. You know that Ganpati is the heart and soul of Mumbai, so the spirits are very high.
Are your students satisfied? Like when you switch from a teacher to a principal, so there are certain students, those who are being by Seema ma'am, leave the school and some sort of that, because the nature you are having, as per I predict, that you are having a very sweet nature, and the students, those who have teached by you, and they really remember you all the time, and whenever there are some sort of talking over the principals, the teachers, those who are inspiring, and the favorite teacher, as we can say. So there is one more name, this Dr. Seema. She is being a very
My students, most of the students whom I have taught, they are well settled in life now. There are many batches of boards I have taught, and the best part with this, I think, the social media is I'm connected with all my students. Some of few of my students got married also, so they do invite us for their marriage, and I think that is the beauty of being a teacher, that your children are always connected with you. They are all over the world. If I see some or other student is there.
Okay, what qualities that you appreciate in a student or in a teacher? There are certain qualities that everybody prefer, whether anybody. So what qualities that you always prefer?
So I prefer that the person needs to be honest. You know, when you're honest, definitely you have the courage to tell the truth. When you're honest, you're very honest with your work. You're always honest with your students. You're always honest with everything. Simple, values in life like honesty and integrity and good interpersonal skills are good enough. Then you can shape a person whichever way you want to shape. And you need to be courageous. You need to be courageous. It's perfectly all right if a child says that, ma'am, you're wrong here. And when you are courageous, as a person also, you accept it wrong with grace, because none of us are perfect.
What kind of world that you, everyone have a fairy tale world. So what kind of world that you are looking for? Like if you get a chance.
No, I don't have a fairy tale world. I have a very, very innovative and sci-fi kind of world, technologically driven, but value-based. So that is what I believe. a world wherein technology is at the peak, but at the same time, values are at the peak. So a blend of technology and value is the kind of world I look forward to.
Okay, aap kai, internationally you are honored and so many of platforms as I can read. So is there sometime that there is a message to you that you have to be there for your like that achievement, and you are feeling that I never think that I like is something happened ki kai baar aapne socha ho ki main uske kabil nahi hu and after that you achieve that, is there something like that?
Nay, I never thought that I am not worthy of that, because if I was not worthy of that, I wouldn't have got it. So I am, see, you need to be, first of all, when I told you honesty, you need to be very honest with your own self. You need to be very honest with your work. Okay. And you should be courageous, as I told you. So when you are courageous, you know that you are ready to take that zone, which is not comfortable, but you are taking that because that is necessary. So for me, my values, my integrity are very, very important. And I know if I'm getting something, I had worked for it. I trust my own self. जब आपको खुद पे भरोसा होता है तो आपको पता होता है आपको जो मिल रहा है उसके लिए आपने काम किया है, और जो अगर सपोज जिस चीज के लिए मैंने काम नहीं किया है उस चीज को मैं एक्सेप्ट ही नहीं करती.
That's
so life is simple, why it's complicated.
That's really amazing. There are some teachers or some students that they are might not be the favorite one, but they, because of their some qualities, you appreciate them, and in this process they might be some more near than others. So tell me some of the names, that is few of the teachers, few of the students, and what is the motto of your school?
See, the motto is we are trying to shape the Indians, all Indian children who are there. We are trying to shape the children to become a global citizen. We all know that they need to be global citizen, but yes, with lot of strong values and ethos that will make them feel proud of their own country. That's one thing. And when it comes to favorite students, favorite teachers, I think we need to rise above that. Yes, we do have some favorite students, but then that should not become the bias. You should never be biased towards few students or few teachers. Then you are not doing your work properly. Yes, favorites, सबके होते हैं. There are so many names. It's not that favorites will be always the one who are, who are the academically bright one. Favorites are those also who are the most naughtiest one, who are always standing out of the class the way they used to be initially. Now there is no punishment system, nothing, and we, I don't believe also in that punishment system. So the thing is, favorite is fine, but I don't think any educator should be biased any child or any teacher. Then we are wrong. Because all the children, when they come out of their house to school,
if you are talking about
all the children need to be equal.
If you are talking about me, then I am one kind of like I am might be the only student that I am very near to my principal. जो हमारे ये don't spread like ये चीज मुझे बोलनी नहीं चाहिए, but I am the one. Teachers भी एक तरह से हम उसे कह सकते हैं कि डर, because teachers को कहीं ना कहीं they are उन्हें थोड़ा सा डर होता है तो for principal. ओके, सो मैं तो जब कई बार शरारते करता हूँ तो दे आर बीइंग कि ऐश्वर्य को मत ले जाओ क्योंकि वो शांत रहने वालों में से नहीं है. दे आर हैविंग ही इज हैविंग अ लॉयर नेचर, नॉट लायर बट लॉयर, बिकॉज वो कुछ ऐसे वो रखतेगा देन आपको पहले पूरी तह तक जाना चाहिए था फिर मेरे पास. सो आई एम वन ऑफ द फेवरेट वन हु इज बीइंग लाइक हु इज लाइक अ एजुकेटर इन माय स्कूल. आई एम काउंटेड एज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट, मैं अपने आप अपनी तारीफ नहीं करूंगा, बट इट इन सम वेज. सो मैडम आई थिंक
आई बिलीव ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स शुड गेट दैट काइंड ऑफ प्लेटफॉर्म. इट शुडंट बी रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू 1, 2, 3 स्टूडेंट्स. इट शुड बी गिवन टू एवरीवन. द डोर शुड बी ओपन. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट प्रिंसिपल्स गिवन, आई थिंक द डोर शुड ऑलवेज बी ओपन फॉर एनी चाइल्ड टू वॉक इन एंड जस्ट स्पीक. दैट इज व्हाई आई स्टार्टेड दिस प्रिंसिपल की पाठशाला, बिकॉज आई पर्सनली बिलीव देयर शुडंट बी एनी बायसेस. All the children, when they come to school, they look for same kind of appreciation. Definitely, some are mediocre, some are average, some are over average, some are exceptionally good. But that is just one quality. That is just about academics and other things. Otherwise, all the children deserve the equal amount of appreciation. I very strongly vouch for that.
That's really amazing. You are having great ideology. And I think today, we are having an enough session because we have another. So thank you very much. I can't thank you enough for connecting with us. It's on a very short notice because you are having a busy schedule, as we all can see. And thank you for sharing so many of amazing ideas. And I wish if I ever get any other chance to work with you, then I always prepare you. And being an educator, you are really doing well. And before ending, can you please tell me about your Pathshala, like a brief about your Pathshala?
See, Principal Ki Pathshala, as I told you, is an initiative wherein I want to hear to each and every child. The youth has so much to speak. And this generation does not have anyone to listen to them most of the time. When we talk about metropolitan cities, both the parents are working. So most of the time, there is no one to listen to the children. So this endeavor started because I wanted to listen to each and every child. And I wanted to provide that platform wherein the fear that principal is coming on ground should not be there. Principal is again a human who is there to ensure that each and every child who walks to school is safe. Each and every teacher who walks to school is safe. They are growing intellectually, physically, psychologically, emotionally, and they are at the safe place. So for me, that is more important. So Principal Ki Pathshala is not only for students, for teachers also. We always have open communication. I strongly believe in the teamwork. And for me, as I always say, it's a very cliche thing for me, for the student, by the student, with the student, always. They are my top priority when it comes to my work. And my teachers are always team. For me, it cannot be X, Y, Z name. It has to be team. So if everybody grows together, the team grows. And if the team grows, everybody grows together. So it's very simple. And the simplest mantra that our school follows is, happy teacher equates to happy student. Happy students equate to happy parents. Happy parents equates to happy school. Again, as I told you, life is simple. We complicate it so much.
That's really amazing. Okay, and just name who is your ideal person to whom you used to follow.
There are many. Naming one will be difficult. There are many, but I'll name a complicated one. That is the person I see every morning in the mirror. That is my ideal person because that person always pricks me and say, this is what I have to do. There are still a lot of milestones that I have to achieve. So definitely the image that I see in mirror is my ideal, and because that image is free to tell me you are wrong here, free to criticize me, free to appreciate me, and free to guide me.
Okay, any actor or actress that you are worthy for, like you love to look the movies and all?
No, I just like everyone. It depends upon the plot of the movie and the kind of acting they have done, but I do not have any favorite per se.
Favorite food?
Favorite food. I like Indian food.
Okay. Would you like to it's really you are used to visit all the world. So this is really being amazing, and I think there's 2 minutes left. So thank you very much from the whole team of ESNF. It's really being amazing to have you today, and thank you again. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Have a lovely evening ahead and a lovely life ahead. So you are, as I told you, you are young, you have so much to do, but at the same time, ensure that you are making your roots so strong that your wings are mighty. Stay grounded, keep on growing, but stay grounded. It's very important to stay grounded. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.